This week on Maker Update, a Nixie Tube alternative for the 21st century, Arduino puts your sketches in the cloud, robot cocktails, laser cats, making it rain, making music, and making the cookies. It's Wednesday, December 21st. I'm Donald Bell, and welcome to another episode of Maker Update, my last one of 2016, since I'm going to be taking next week off. It's going to be a light week next week anyways, but not this week. We got an action-packed episode here, so let's jump right into it, starting with the project of the week. Check out Lixie by Connor Nishijima. If you love the look and glow of vintage Nixie Tube displays but wish they were bigger and more affordable, the Lixie has you covered. Instead of a hot, fragile vacuum tube, you've got 10 panes of acrylic sandwiched together and lit up on their edges with LEDs. Each pane is etched 0 through 9 and carefully aligned and filtered with the LEDs so that only one number is shown at a time when you're looking at it face on. Using an Arduino, you can call up each number easily because you're essentially just telling little strips of LEDs to turn on or off. The project is super open. It's certified open source hardware. You can find the templates, the software, the circuit board files, the components. It's all there to play with. That said, Connor is also making a batch to sell on Tindy in January, priced at $40 shipped, so get on that waitlist now if you want in. The longer I do this show, the more I realize I'm totally infatuated with weird display technologies like e-ink, flip dots, OLED, and now these. And I need about four of them to make something like a clock, which is kind of like an obvious way to go with these. But you could probably get away with just two if you wanted to make like a temperature readout. But also, like, it doesn't even have to really be numbers, really, right? You could have your own custom etched acrylic and have it flip through different emojis, or you could have it flip through different words, or even flip through different cells of animation in like a drawing. You can find a link to the Hackaday post for this project over on my show notes for this video, or also on the show post on MakerProjectLab.com. And now for news. This past week, Arduino updated its web-based IDE, which honestly, I didn't even know they had. This is an online editor and browser plugin that allows you to program an Arduino microcontroller board right from your browser. With the update, you can now upload your existing stash of Arduino sketches as a zip file and have access to them wherever you go. Personally, I'm still used to just using the standalone Arduino software, and I don't see myself changing anytime soon, but I could see where this would be really useful in a classroom setting where you've got people on shared computers and you're juggling accounts or on Chromebooks. That makes sense to me. Plus, it's just a free way to back up your Arduino sketches, so who's complaining? Also, I completely spaced on the Roboxotica Cocktail Robotics Competition in Vienna, which took place December 8th through the 11th. It's a dream of mine to compete in or at least attend this someday. Fortunately, fan of the show, Clemens Mayer, took some video of his time there. You can see his complete video on his YouTube channel, Mayer Makes. If you haven't heard of this event before, it's basically a boozy challenge for makers to create and showcase contraptions that automatically serve alcohol. It's like a drunken maker fair, but in Austria, so everyone seems more charming and smarter than you. It's also an answer to my most common complaint about robots, which is that until they can drive me around, most consumer robotic products that I hear about just seem useless. But if a robot can make me the perfect Manhattan, I'm all in. The winning robot this year was Gaston, which is a motorized robot that moves along a path. You put your empty drink on it and punch in a request for a refill, and it refills your drink and brings it back to you. Speaking of awesome maker events that I wasn't there for, this past Sunday was the ITP Winter Show in New York. There's a list of exhibited student projects I'll include in the show notes. Some of the highlights I found include this box of secrets that will print you out someone else's secret in exchange for recording one of yours. There's also this giant mechanical eye that you can text your Instagram name to, and it opens up, and a display in the middle of the eye flashes through your Instagram photos. And I can't not mention laser cats, a project where you put on big cat gloves and score points by chasing after a big projected laser pointer. Sounds like the perfect chaser after a night of robot cocktails, right? And now for more projects. I found three projects this week that look both awesome and reasonably achievable. The first is this DIY instant camera sent in to me by Fabian Chateau from the Adacore blog. The camera combines a thermal printer, like a receipt printer, an LCD screen, a LiPo battery pack, and an all-in-one camera module called the OpenMV. The prints are in grayscale, but they're really kind of beautiful in their own way. Building the project as shown would easily put you over $100, so you'd really have to love that grayscale printer aesthetic to justify this, but man, I'm pretty close. Like I said, I'm a sucker for weird display technology. While I'm feeling financially reckless, I also found this Make It Rain box that uses an Arduino, a DC motor, a microphone, and a servo to pinch and shoot out a shower of money whenever you clap your hands. Honestly, if you load this thing up with Monopoly money, I think it would be a hilarious gag to have around the house. The documentation for this is really good, and it's over on the Arduino Project Hub. Finally, every once in a while there is a project that makes me almost angry at how simple yet awesome it is. That's how I felt when I saw Lynn from Darbin Orvar's Fairy Ball project over on Instructables. Using a block of wood, a clear Christmas ornament, and some battery-powered fairy lights, you've got this oddly magical little accent bulb that I think would look cool at really any time of the year. It could also make a great last-minute gift if you have the supplies handy. All right, now for this week's roundup of tips and tools. Adafruit has two new products that I thought were pretty exciting. The first is this Raspberry Pi hat from PiMoroni that is this awesome little demo board with color-changing lights, an alphanumeric display, three capacitive buttons, a piezo buzzer, and a temperature and barometric pressure sensor for detecting the weather. Plus, it has a little cute pirate on it, and you can get the whole thing for just $25. It was intended for use for Android developers to get started with IoT applications for the new Android Things platform that was announced last week. And good for you if that's what you want to use it for, but the PiMoroni folks have a whole GitHub resource just for Pi users who want to play with this thing using Python. I think it's a good value just for that, and a cool design. Adafruit also has a cool new add-on board for their little Arduino-compatible feather boards. This one's called the MusicMaker. It's $20. It just stacks right on and adds audio playback to your project. It supports MP3, AAC, FLAC, AUG, WAV, and even MIDI files stored on microSD. I like it. It looks like a solid way to add audio to even small projects. It could be another tool for building the perfect Billy Bass hack. For fans of 3D printing, Thingiverse has a collection of some of their most popular designs of 2016 voted on by users. There's a lot of cool things on here I hadn't seen before, like this Egyptian-themed infinity mirror, so check that out. And while I was listening to the excellent Making It podcast, I heard David Picciuto mention a site for quickly drawing up and exporting 3D printable cookie cutter designs. The site's called cookiecaster.com. It's free and super easy to create and preview custom shapes for your holiday cookies. All right, and that's our last episode of Maker Update for 2016. That brings us to a close. 15 episodes in, I want to thank all of you guys for helping me get this show off the ground this year. I feel really good about where we are right now. We've got the subscribers, we've got the format roughly, right? And I hope you guys are still into it because I'm still into making these and I'm excited to make a fresh batch of these for you guys in 2017. Okay, so have a great holiday, hug your loved ones, and I'll see you next year.